dot product of, we have to discuss the dot and cross product of two vectors. First we will discuss dot product. Dot product is also called scalar product of two vectors. A scalar product of vector is defined as vector A dot vector B, which is equal to A B cos theta, where A here is mod of vector A, B here is mod of vector B, and theta is angle between vector A and vector B. It is also called a scalar product because the result is actually a scalar. A dot B may be positive, may be negative, may be zero. Here, if the dot product of the two vectors is positive, if A dot B is positive, means the angle between them is acute. If the dot product is zero, means the two vectors are perpendicular. If the dot product of two vectors is negative, then the angle between them is obtuse. These are the three conclusions which we can draw while taking the dot product of vector A and vector B. As we know, I cap dot I cap. So this is vector I cap. This is also vector I cap. So angle between I cap and I cap is 0. So I can say I cap dot I cap is mod of I cap in place of A. Here it is I cap. Mod of I cap is 1. Mod of I cap is also 1. And the angle between these two is 0. So I dot I is into cos. I dot I is 1 into 1 into cos 0, which is equal to 1. In the same way, J dot J is also 1. K dot K cap is also 1. But I dot J, this is I cap. And this is J cap. As we know, the angle between I cap and J cap is 90 degree. So mod of I cap is 1, mod of J cap is 1, but cos 90 is 0. So I cap dot J cap is 0. So J dot K is also 0 and K cap dot I cap is also 0. Now we have to take the dot product of A, that is equal to 2 I cap plus 3 J cap. Find the dot product of A, that is 2 I cap plus 3 J cap, and B, that is equal to 4 I cap plus 2 J cap. So A dot B can be written as 2 I cap plus 3 J cap. In place of A, I can write it as A as 2 I cap plus 3 J cap from here. And in place of B, I can write here 4 I cap plus 2 J cap. Now I will multiply this A dot B as 2 I cap multiplied by taking the dot product of 4 I cap plus 2 J cap. Plus 3j, it is 3j dot of 4i plus 2j, which is equal to a dot b, it is 4 into 2, that is 8. For a scalar, I dot product is simply multiplication. So 4 into 2 is 8, I dot I is 1. 2 into 2, that is 4, I dot j. 3 into 4, 12, j dot i. 3 into 2, that is 6, j dot j. So it is 1, I dot I is 1, I dot J is 0, J dot J is 0. So these two terms will vanish. We get 8 plus 6, that is equal to 40. So A dot B here is only 40. Whereas we can also do dot product like this. I have to take the dot product A dot B. So I will put here A, 2 I cap plus 3 J cap, and B here. Of A and B are multiplied together. So it is 4 into 2, that is equal to 8. This is 3 into 2, that is 6, and both are added, so it will get 40. Dot product is used to calculate the component of a vector along another vector. Suppose this is vector A, this is vector B, this is vector B, this is theta. So I can say this length is A cos theta. This is A cos theta. A cos theta can also be calculated from A dot B. We know A dot B is AB cos theta, or A cos theta is vector A dot vector B by mod of vector B. So this is called component of vector A. This is A cos theta is called length of component of A along vector B. This is A sin theta. This is A sin theta. So this dot product is also used to calculate the projection of one vector along another vector. Similarly, we can say B cos theta, which is projection of vector B b cos theta can be calculated by can be calculated as vector a dot vector b divided by mod of a. A sin theta can also be calculated by root over a square minus a cos theta square. So this is a sin theta mod of a sin theta. We know this magnitude is a. This is a right angle triangle. So we can say a cos theta square plus a sin theta square is equal to a square. So from here you can say a square is equal to a cos theta square plus a sin theta square. So a sin theta can be written as a root over a square minus a cos theta square. This is the component of vector a perpendicular to vector b. Now for example, find the length of component of vector a along vector b. This is vector a, this is vector b. So we'll draw vector a, this is vector b. Let this angle be theta. I will take component of vector b. So I will draw a line like this. This length is a cos theta. So a cos theta can be written as a dot b. As we know, a dot b is 2 into 1, that is 2, plus 4 into 3, that is equal to 12. It is equal to 14. So a dot b, vector a dot vector b is equal to 14. So I will write here 14. And the magnitude of vector b is root over 3 square plus 1, that is root 10. So a cos theta is a dot b divided by mod b. That is equal to, as we know, a dot b is 14 and mod of b is root 10. So it is 14 by root 10. This is 14 by root 10. This is length, this is projection of vector a along vector b. Next question. Find the dot product of I cap, j cap, k cap and this. So let vector a, which is equal to I cap plus j cap plus k cap, and vector b, that is equal to I cap minus j cap plus k cap. So vector a dot vector b is equal to, coefficient of I and I is 1, I 1 and minus 1, it is minus 1, and this is again 1, so it is equal to 1. So the answer is A. Find the dot product of, find the dot product of this and this. As we know, A, which is equal to 1 I cap plus 2 j cap minus 3 k cap, it is given. Now vector b is 2 I cap plus 4 j cap plus 2 k cap. Now a dot b, for a dot b, we'll take the product of coefficient of I cap first. It is equal to 2 into 1, that is 2, plus 4 into 2, that is equal to 8, plus minus 3 into 2 is minus 6. So it comes out to be 4. Here it is 2. So a dot b here is 4. Give that, given that a is equal to 3 I cap minus j cap plus 7 k cap, whereas b is equal to 5 I cap this. The direction cosine of a plus b, as we know, a plus b, vector a plus vector b, that is equal to vector c, which is equal to 5 plus 3, this I cap plus I cap, 5 plus 3 is 8 I cap, plus 0 j cap, plus 9 plus 7 is 16 k cap. Now as we know, if this is our x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, this is x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So our vector is 8 i cap, so this is 8 i cap plus 16 k cap, it is like this. This is 8 I cap and this is 16 k cap. This is our vector C. This is our vector C. So we can say from here that this vector C makes an angle of 90 degree with y axis. So its direction cosine is cos beta, that is equal to beta is 90 degree. As we know, it makes an angle 90 degree with y axis. So cos 90 is 0. The angle between z axis and vector this is, we know this is our z axis. Suppose this is vector A, this is our vector A, and this is our z axis. We know the unit vector on z axis is k cap. So now we can say this angle, let it be theta. So I can say cos theta is vector A dot vector k divided by mod of A and mod of k, which is 1, which is equal to, what is A dot k? We can say A dot k is root 2. A dot k is root 2 divided by mod of A is root over 2 square plus 1 plus 1, that is root 4. So it is equal to 1 by root 2. So theta is 45 degree. After dot product, we will discuss cross product of two vectors. Cross product is also called vector product because the resultant is a vector. So A cross B is written as A into B into sine theta into n cap. Here, this A is A and B, both are magnitude of vector A and B. Theta is angle between vector A and vector B. N cap is a unit vector. N cap here is a unit vector perpendicular to A and B both, and its direction is given by right hand screw rule, which we will discuss here. Suppose this is vector A, this is vector B. So if I want to write A cross B, A cross B means I will rotate this A towards this vector B through a smaller angle, and the thumb will point in the direction, if the finger points in the direction of rotation, then the thumb will point in the direction of this n cap. So this is the direction of n cap. Again I am saying A cross B means we will rotate this vector A towards this vector B and hold the finger like this. If the direction of rotation is represented by the direction of rotation of this finger, then the thumb will point in the direction of this n cap. This law is also called right hand screw rule. See the movement of a screw. If we rotate this screw in the direction of the rotation of this finger, then the thumb will point in the direction of this vector n cap. See, this is vector A, this is vector B. A cross B will give me vector C. So I will rotate this vector A towards this vector B. If this is B here, I will rotate it in this direction. If B is here, I will rotate it in this direction. If B is here, I will rotate in this direction. Then this is the vector C, which is also the direction of n cap. So this is called right hand screw rule. See, the rotation of finger will point in this figure. I will rotate this A towards B. So A cross B here is A cross B. I will rotate this A towards B. Then the thumb will go downward, and that is the direction of n cap. Here A cross B means we have to rotate A in this direction. In that situation, the thumb will point upward, and this is the direction of n cap. Here are some standard vector cross product. So I cross I, as we know, A cross B means AB sin theta is AB sin theta into n cap. So I cross I. In place of A, it is I. In place of B, it is I. So we know the angle between I and I is 0. So I cross I is 1 into 1. Mod of I is 1. Mod of I is again 1. And the sign 0 is 0. So it is a null vector. Similarly, J cross J is also 0. K cross K is also 0. Now I cross J. I cross J cap. So I cap cross J cap. Mod of I cap is 1. Mod of J cap is also 1. And the angle between I and J is 90 degrees. So it is also sine 90 is 1. And the direction, if we rotate I cap towards this J cap, then the thumb will point in the direction of K cap. So it is actually K cap. So I cap cross J cap is K cap. Similarly, J cross K. J cross K means we have to rotate J towards K. So it is in the direction of I cap. So it is I cap. K cross I. If you see K cross I, if we rotate K towards I, it is J cap. Similarly, J cross I is minus K cap. K cross J is minus I cap. And I cross K is minus J cap. Now the question is, find the cross product of A, 2i cap plus 3j cap and B. So suppose this is vector C, which is equal to vector A cross, this is vector A cross vector B. So this is equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap cross B means 2i cap plus j cap. This is equal to 2i cap cross 2i cap plus j plus 3j cap cross 2i cap plus j cap. This is equal to 2 into 2, that is 4. I cap cross I cap means 0. Plus 2 into 1, that is 2. I cross J, as we know, I cross J is K cap. I cross J is K cap. So it is K cap. Plus 3 into 2, that is 6. And J cross I, we know J cross I is minus K cap. So I will put here, it is minus K cap. Plus 3 into 1, that is 3. J cross J, that is 0. So it comes out to be minus 4 K cap. This is the final answer. This question can again be solved by another method, that is called determinant method. So I will write it as this: A cross B means we have to draw a determinant. Substitute here I, J, K. Put the coefficient of I cap here. Put the coefficient of J cap here. K cap, since K cap is not here, so I will substitute here 0. Similarly, second position, this is the first position. This is the second position. In second position, the vector B is there. So I will substitute the coefficient of I cap of vector A here, it is 2. J cap coefficient is 1, I will substitute here 1. And K cap is not there, so it is 0. So A cross B, I will substitute the coefficient of A first and then coefficient of B second. Now we will substitute a sign here, plus, minus, plus. Now this can be written as, we will take I cap. Now if I take I cap, I will leave this row and this column and multiply this 3 into 0, that is 0, minus this one, 3, 1 into 0, that is 0. Now this sign is minus, so I will write here minus. This is J cap, so this is J cap. Now if I take this one, I will leave this row and this column and take the remaining one, 2 into 0, so it is 2 into 0 minus 2 into 0, it is 2 into 0 plus Now it is plus, so it is plus k cap. Leaving this row and this column, we get 2 into 1, it is 2 into 1 minus 3 into 2, that is 6. So this comes out to be minus 4 k cap. This is the answer. This is determinant method which we will use. Now find A cross B if A is 2 I cap plus 2 j cap plus k cap and B is 3 I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. So A cross B, I will make a determinant here. A cross B means the first position is A and in second position it is B. So I will make a determinant, substitute here I cap, j cap, k cap. First I will take the coefficient of A, it is 2, it is 2, it is 1. Now after that B, the coefficient of B here is 3, minus 2 and 3. Now first I will take I cap, substituting this is A cross B is equal to, this is positive, this is negative, this is positive. I cap, I will leave this row and this column. So it is 2 into 3, that is 6, minus 1 into minus 2 is minus 2, so it become plus 2. Plus, now it is minus j, so minus j cap. Leaving this row and column, it is 2 into 3, that is 6, minus 3 into 1, that is 3. I will substitute here a positive sign, plus k cap into 2 into minus 2 is minus 4, minus 3 into 2, that is 6. So A cross B is equal to 8 I cap minus 3 j cap and it is minus 10 k cap. So this is the value of A cross B here. Next question is, now the property, if A cross B is 0, then the two non-zero vector must be parallel or anti-parallel. As we know, A cross B is 0 and if A and B are not 0, then they are always, the angle between them is either 0 or 180, because we know sine 0 is 0 and sine 180 is also 0. The area of triangle formed by vector A and vector B is half of mod of A cross B, because as we know, the area of triangle is given by, this is vector A, this is vector B. The triangle formed by these two vector, this angle is theta. The triangle formed by these two vector is, its area is given by half into A into B into sine theta. So the area of triangle is also equal to 1 by 2 mod of A cross B. For any two vector, there is a question, for any two vector A and B, if A dot B is equal to mod of A cross B, then find the magnitude of C which is equal to A plus B. We know it is given that A dot B, A dot B means it is A B cos theta and mod of A cross B is A B sin theta, because mod of n cap is 1. So it implies that both are equal, means tan theta is equal to 1, it means ki theta is 45 degree, means the angle between the two vector is 45 degree. Now C is equal to A plus B, so mod of C is mod of A plus B, which is equal to root over A square plus B square plus twice AB cos theta. Now we know cos theta is 45 degree, theta is 45 degree, so cos 45 is 1 by root 2, so it comes out to be A square plus B square plus root 2 AB, that's all. This is the answer. The question is, the magnitude of vector product of two vector is root 3, so mod of A cross B is equal to root 3 times A dot B. It means A cross B means A B sin theta is equal to root 3 times A dot B means A B cos theta. So from here we get tan theta, that is equal to root 3, or theta is equal to 60 degree, or it is also equal to pi by 3. So C is the right answer. Question based on some application of vector. Force this is force F1 is given by I cap minus 2 j cap. Force F2 is given by minus I cap plus 2 j cap. Act through a point given by R1, that is equal to k cap, and R2, that is equal to 3 k cap. We know the moment of the force is given by R cross F. So the total moment is R1 cross F1 plus R2 cross F2. Now this is equal to R1 means k cap, it is k cap cross F1 means I minus 2j plus R2 means 3k cap, it is 3k cap cross F2 means minus I cap plus 2j cap. So this is equal to k cross I. As we know k cross I is j cap minus 2 into k cross j is minus I cap plus 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. K cross I is again j cap plus 6 k cross j cap is again minus I cap. So this is equal to j cap plus 2 I cap minus 3 j cap minus 6 I cap. So this is equal to minus 2 j cap minus 4 I cap. So this one is the right answer. Next question. The direction of three force, 1 newton, 2 newton, 3 newton, act at a point are parallel to side of triangle taken in order. This is 1 newton, this is 2 newton, and this is 3 newton. The magnitude of their resultant, we know the magnitude of the resultant. So if you see, this is 1 newton, this is 2 newton, this is 3 newton. So 1 will cancel out. Here, this is 1 newton, 1 newton, 1 newton will become 0. So, in this situation, it is 2 newton. So, it is 1 newton remaining. Here, it is 3 newton. So, here 2 newton is remaining. So, we have to actually find the resultant of 1 newton and 2 newton. So, the resultant force Fr is given by root over 2 square plus 1 square plus 2, A means 2 into 1. Into cos 120 degree. Cos 120 degree is cos 120 degree. So this is equal to root over 4 plus 1 plus 2 into 2 into cos 180 is minus 1 by 2. So this 2 will cancel out. We get it as root over 3. This is the answer. So the resultant is root 3 newton. Force proportional to AB. Suppose this triangle ABC. AB, BC and 2CA. We know vector AB plus vector BC plus 2 times vector CA. As we know, this is the resultant. The resultant force is given by vector AB plus BC. As we know, in triangle, vector AB plus BC plus AC is 0. So, it is AB plus BC plus CA plus CA. So AB plus BC plus CA, this is 0 because it is forming triangle. So the resultant force is along CA. The magnitude of scalar product of two vectors is 8. Scalar product means A dot B, which is equal to AB cos theta, and cross product means A cross B. Its modulus is AB into sin theta. It is given that the scalar product of two vectors is 8. It is 8, and the vector product is 8 root 3. So I can say tan theta is equal to root 3. So if tan theta is root 3, it means theta is equal to 60 degree, or it is also 120 degree, because we have taken the modulus here. So it may be possible that angle may be 60 degree or 120 degree. So both answers are correct. So it is B and C. A bird moved from point, suppose this is our x axis, y axis and z axis. The bird starts moving from this point A. This is point A, which is 1, minus 2 and 3. 2 point this B, which is 4, 2 and 3. This is the direction of movement of bird. So we can say n cap. What is n cap? N cap can be taken as 4 minus 1, that is 3 I cap, plus 2 minus minus 2 is 4 j cap, plus 0 k cap, divided by 5, because mod of this is 5. So it is 3 by 5 I cap plus 4 by 5 j cap. This is n cap along which the bird is moving. The velocity vector. So velocity of bird is given by its magnitude is 10 meter per second multiplied by n cap. So it comes out to be 6 I cap plus 8 j cap. So this is the velocity of the bird. Because the bird is moving from A to B, and we know the coordinate of A, we know the coordinate of B, we can draw a vector like this. This is RB, this is RA. So we can say vector A to B is equal to vector RB minus vector RA. And n cap is vector AB divided by mod of vector AB. This is north, south, east and west. A particle is moving northward. Let the velocity V1 is 5 I cap. I am assuming this as x axis, this as y axis. And finally, it moves to 5 meter per second eastward. A particle moving 5 meter per second in eastward, 5 I cap, its velocity changes to 5 meter per second northward. So final velocity means V2 becomes 5 J cap. So initially it is going in eastward direction, finally it is moving in northward direction. So this is VI and this is VF. So delta V is final velocity means V2 minus V1. So this comes out to be minus 5 I cap plus 5 J cap. If I draw this vector, that is 5 I cap and 5 J cap, so it is minus 5 I cap, this is minus 5 I cap plus 5 J cap, so it is plus 5 J cap. And this vector is delta V, which is in the direction of northwest. So first, the change in velocity vector magnitude is mod of delta V is root over 5 square plus 5 square, which is equal to 5 root So the change in velocity is 5 root 2 meter per second along northwest direction. The question is the resultant of two forces F1 and F2. Suppose this force F1 is P. The resultant of these two P is equal to root over F1 square plus F2 square plus 2F1 F2 cos theta. This is P. If F2 is reversed, the resultant is Q. Means Q is equal to, when we reverse F2, we get Q. It means this is F1 square plus F2 square minus 2F1 F2 cos theta. Because when we reverse this F2, the angle between the vector F1 and F2 becomes pi minus theta. So, the value of P square, so we can say P square plus Q square is clearly 2 times F1 square plus F2 square. This is the answer. Out of the following pair, the resultant cannot be 8 Newton, 4 Newton. So we know the resultant of 2 and 2, these are the two forces. The resultant is either 0 for this, the minimum, the resultant lies between 0 and 4. So it is possible it can give 4 Newton. This 2 and 6, the minimum value is 4 and the maximum is 8. So this 4 is possible here also. Here it is 2 and 4. So the minimum value possible here is 2 Newton and the maximum is 6 Newton. So 4 lie in this range. So it can also give 4 Newton. Here the minimum is 6 and the maximum is 10. So 4 is not in this range. So for this, the resultant of this 2 Newton and 8 Newton can never give 4 Newton. So the answer is D. The question is, if mod of A plus B, we know mod of A plus B is A square plus B square plus twice AB cos theta. And we know mod of A minus B is equal to root over A square plus B square minus 2AB cos theta. From here, we can say cos theta is equal to 0. It means theta is equal to 90 degree. So the angle between vector and vector B is 90 degree. Means we can say the two vectors are mutually perpendicular. Find the angle between vector A and B. So we can say cos theta here is vector A dot vector B divided by mod of A into mod of B. It will give you cos theta, and which is equal to cos theta is 25 by 29.